Welcome. Here we are again. There's no like pre-show antics, like when you're about to walk on stage. You're sort of in a dressing room and you have like your little rituals and usually people to be in that moment with, but here it's just kind of like waiting and staring at your phone, and then eventually you just press live. Very weird. I wanna control you. I wanna know who you're talking to, so tell me why you're laughing at your phone. Who you know in 410? I wanna take all your time. Your family hates me cause I've isolated you from them. You don't understand, we're so intense, and I'm lame for you. My chanel, the page all filled with your name, it says my baby blue. I still go through your purse in Columbus Circle. I love you like we're 16. La 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 la. I don't mean that as a good thing. La 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 la. I'm completely in palm and in my head. Don't believe me when I say I'm not upset. I love you like we're 16. La, 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 la. I wanna marry you. I have 3 kids with your attitude. We'll spend the summers overseas. Your winters join Winnetka, Bowling League. Got this fixation with proving your dedication. How high I could fly your patience and degrees of aviation. I guess I'm lame. Extreme strung chords straight to me. They say my baby blue. What is cursing on Park Avenue and feeling like 3 Xanax do? I love you like we're 16. La 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 la. I don't mean that as a good thing. La 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 la. I'm completely in palm and in my head. Don't believe me when I say I'm not obsessed. I love you like we're 16. La 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 la. Will I kiss your neck and we sail away? Forget, we're never not okay. I'll write you songs that are up with your key, but you'll hum along forever, baby. I love you like we're 16. La, 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 la. I love you like we're 16. La, 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 la. I didn't want to do applause tonight, so I did booing. I can't do that. I just can't feel good about doing the same show every week with the same applause, and there's only so many applause sequences on YouTube. So now we boo. So it's been kind of fun to go through old songs and sort of see which ones I've not played in a super long time or haven't played ever, because there's a bunch of songs that I'm realizing I've never played, and since starting the band, I've definitely shied away from a lot of the older stuff. So this has been kind of cool and an opportunity to learn some older stuff. And this is one of them. This is a song I wrote with my buddy Josh, also known as Flux Pavilion.
And he's one of my favorite people. I absolutely love him. He's such a good dude. And yeah, we wrote a song. It's probably 4 years old now, 5 years old, called Emotional. And it goes like this. For me no more. Don't know how to love without a war, with a disease without a cure. You wanna hurt just a little, hurt just a little more. We are casually cruel. You were my training wheels in April Fool. Our tolerance is full. Don't wanna hurt anybody, hurt anyone more. Ain't this a pity, watching your pretty smile so warm? And I am already halfway out the door. You're gonna kiss me, say you're a tipsy baby, I lose my cool. When I get emotional, when I get emotional. Get emotional too. And I get emotional. You're comfortably dysfunctional. I get emotional. Our detention after school. Or November in a swimming pool, speeding car running on fumes. We can drive just a little more. You're a trampoline with wings, we're only jumping out of tendency. But now we both want different things, so I'll be cutting off these strings. Ain't this a pity, watching your pretty smile so warm? Already halfway out the door. You're gonna kiss me, say you're a tipsy baby, I lose my cool. And I get emotional. And I get emotional. And you get emotional too. I get emotional, we are comfortably dysfunctional. I didn't mean what I said, but I said what I meant. It won't happen again till it happens again. It's nothing personal. I get emotional. And that's that one. It's missing all the EDMness, all the electronic, all the drop, all the pew 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 pew. It's missing all that stuff. It's funny actually revisiting some of these songs because I realize how, when you're working with DJs on tunes, a lot of their songs are about their drops and how it sonically sounds. So you're not really writing like full real choruses, you're kind of writing these like one word tagline things. So there's a lot of times where I'm like, oh, I'm really into the verses of this song, but then it gets to a chorus, I'm like, oh, it was just one word. It was just saying one word over and over again. But it was kind of the nature of the beast of what those songs were, so. I grew up in New York, and my beautiful wife, who's watching tonight from bed with our dude, Luca. She films a television show there, and we live in New York for a good part of the year. Usually, this year, we did not. But the last time I was there, I was walking through New York, and it was the first time I'd been back there in a very long time, since sort of not living there. Kind of lived most of my adult life in Los Angeles, and walking through the city for the first time just brought back a lot of feelings, and it got me thinking. A lot of things that were really familiar, and it just sort of framed life in a different way than I'd seen it before, because I don't know, you only get that experience once, kind of going back to the place you grew up and seeing what's changed about it and what's changed about you, and sort of just what that feels like. So I wrote this song on a walk one day.
Out a business restaurant with someone's dream once. I can still see you in college, putting on your cherry lip gloss. But time did what it does, and it happened to us. The people who we thought we'd be call out who we become. And I came back to Manhattan like a tourist does. From my taxi seatbelt fastened to which pocket I keep cashing, I sit down in Union Square. I can feel you here, I swear. But I turn around to see it's really nothing. It's just something in the air. It's just something in the air. Father let his wife of 25 years walk out. Think maybe that all happened before they even knew it happened. Too much space between the words, neither one of them felt hurt. Too much damage and her passion couldn't be relearned. Hey, maybe that's their version of what forever is. Built a home on crazy hours for the kids, kept on the power. He still hears her up the stairs, stirs his coffee like he cares. And he turns around to see she isn't coming. It's just something in the air. It's just something in the air. It's the blanket that your mother made when you were young. Why it only has more meaning when the strands all come undone. It's why you sometimes say a prayer while you wear the ring you wear. It's the push when you need hope to keep you going. It's the way that you just know without knowing. It's just something in the air. Down in Union Square, I can feel you here, I swear. But I turn around to see it's really nothing. It's just something in the air.
Yeah. That's that. This has to be the first time in sort of known history that so many performers are performing to absolutely no applause, just consistently. I mean, you've had like a shitty show before where people don't like what you're doing, so they don't really clap or respond, but this is different. It's just, it's constant silence. I'm starting to get used to it though, and I kind of like it. Yeah, I'm looking at the crowd. But it has been a really, really fun opportunity to do these, and maybe self-serving, because I really, really enjoy getting to play these songs, and yeah, a lot of them I haven't gotten to play in a long time, so it's been cool. So this tune after spending many years writing with a lot of electronic artists, I tried making a solo record, and I don't know that I really found what I was looking for until starting Winnetka, but during the solo record, there were some cool songs written that I felt like were sort of the gap between where I was and where I've sort of ended up now. And yeah, this is one of those songs that I never get to play. And a cool story about this song is when I wrote and recorded the song, just like in the bridge, for whatever reason, I was lazy that day and I didn't write a bridge and I just sang the Beck song, Loser, over the bridge. And it just stayed for a while, like on the demo version of the song. So a lot of people were getting used to it, just like my friends, my manager, my band, and those people were like, okay, we're kind of used to this version of it. So what do? You have to go write like a new bridge now? We're like, okay, well, maybe just we'll send it to Beck, knowing that he's going to say absolutely not, because he never like lets artists use his samples or anything like that. So we sent it to Beck, and to our complete surprise, he wrote back a really nice letter that was like, yeah, I really dig the tune, good luck. And he took like a really small percentage when he could have taken so much. So that's my Beck story. We've never met, but we have a credit together, which is pretty cool. This is also in the age of everybody signing up for Tinder, and I decided I was going to write my song about why you shouldn't date me. So that's what this is. Hard to love.
I rule the world from my sweatpants. Got a bitchin' collection of headbands. I don't wanna go out and see a friend's band. Tell me when you've heard enough, enough's enough. OCD with panic attacks. I got a thing for Japanese dry snacks. My voice was on like every fucking house track. Tell me when you've heard enough, enough's enough. So hear me out this time, my love. Tryna be something I'm not. Your friends will tell you, Whitney, are you taking drugs? Cause you see something no one else does. But I'm hard to love. I'm hard to love. Yellow tiger on a leash, diamond in the rough. My heart is in the right places. But I'm hard to love. I'm hard to love. But you mean everything to me. Let me mess it up, cause you're the only one I plus. I'm just hard to love. Day and night at the studio. When I get home, I reek of weed and I'm moody though. Say you can't pick up and follow in my toonie rolls. I've got a red eye to New York. Tomorrow we'll talk. If you want a true gentleman, it's a sport that I don't got any medals in. I'm a soul that your shoes ought to settle in. Give me a little bit of trust, just a touch. So hear me out this time, my love. I'm trying to be something you want. Your friends will tell you, Whitney, are you taking drugs? Smoking from his little black plugs. Cause I'm hard to love. I'm hard to love. Yellow tiger on a leash, diamond in the rough. My heart is in the right places. But I'm hard to love. I'm hard to love. But you mean everything to me. Let me mess it up, cause you're the only one I plus. I'm just hard to love. Soy un perdedor. I'm a loser, baby. So why don't you thrill me? I'm a loser, baby. So why don't you kill me? Cause I'm hard to love. I'm hard to love. Yellow tiger on a leash, diamond in the rough. My heart is in the right places. But I'm hard to love. I'm hard to love. But you mean everything to me. Let me mess it up. Cause you're the only one I plus. I'm just hard to love.
Yeah. That song, actually, I did put that song out. I did it with these guys, Louis the Child, and at the time, I think one of the kids from Louis the Child was like 16, and I flew to Chicago to work with them, and I think he had to leave like high school early to come to the session, which was really cool. Thank you guys for showing up to this thing. So, I got married in December, and before we got married, we did the thing that a lot of couples do. You get together, you break up, you get together, you break up. And during one of those said breakups, I had heard that my soon-to-be wife was seeing someone else, and that struck me with a little bit of comedy, because I just knew she was mine, so that was funny that she was seeing somebody else. It was probably really boring and into dumb shit or something. I'm sure he was really nice. But this was a song I wrote during that period, and I actually never got a chance to put it out, and I've never played it, so it could be a total train wreck, but I came across it on my iTunes, and I was like, I'd forgotten about it, and it struck me. I was like, I remember writing that, I remember the headset I was in, so I wanted to do it, you know? It was also written on piano, so this is going to be interesting. It's called Still Mine to Me. I swear, it's more nerve-wracking to play in front of your cell phone, knowing there's people out there than it is to play on a stage. It's not nerve-wracking to play on a stage, but for some reason, this thing, where you, like, just I'm far enough back that I'm just seeing, I'm also blind, so I can't really see what you're saying, and I can't really see what kind of, like, characters you're sending. I see colors. I'll see, like, a stripe of green. Also really important, don't let me forget to tell you about my aunt. Not my aunt as in my relative aunt, but I'm in a group with ants, and I want to talk about it later. This is called Still Mine to Me.
Dear, the version of us we thought we were, did we crumble by the volume or the lack of words? You come to me in songs and subway platforms. Anyway, I have so much to tell you, I don't know what to say. Somebody's gonna love you now who isn't me. And on the surface you'll have everything, but I know underneath you're still mine to me. You're still mine to me. You're still mine. Help me up, 'cause I don't think I'll come back from this one. I imagine you keep our pictures hid in a box labeled in case. From time to time you wander in. You tell yourself the stories that make our ending make some sense, so you can sleep at night with no defense. You think you found your way to easy love, absent of someone getting close enough. If they did, they'd see you're still mine to me. You're still mine to me. You're still mine. Help me up, 'cause I don't think I'll come back from this one. When the bar turns on the lights, you see the dirt from paradise. You're a stain on my notebook. You're a frame where I won't look. I'm ashamed that I'm still shook up. Somebody's gonna love you now who isn't me. And on the surface you'll have everything. I know underneath you're still mine to be. You're still mine to be. You're still mine. Help me up, cause I don't think I'll come back from this one.
That was right. It worked. It happened. Oh, okay. So, a lot of people have been requesting this next one. And, this one's kind of a funny story. So, it was Christmas. And we had this weird opportunity to write a song for, I think it was for Budweiser, for their Super Bowl commercial. And it was dead in the middle of the holidays, so our turnaround time was, like, it was like the 24th or something. They're like, we need this by the 27th, so we were literally working on Christmas Day, but the bright side of the song was that I got my dad got to sing on it because it was home. So I was like, Dad, come downstairs and sing on these backgrounds with me. So it'll be in the Super Bowl commercial or whatever. And part of the get was like after we wrote the song, I guess it was Budweiser sent like, okay, we need to have these three words in the song. So I was like, fuck, we wrote like kind of this cool song and now it's gonna become this thing. So we put it in the bridge, and then where I was living at the time in Woodland Hills, which is like up north in the valley, there was a Budweiser ad that then had the lyrics from the bridge. So I couldn't get away from it. Every day I would just drive by it, and there it would be. It's like, fuck. And that's extra weird because I don't drink. And I've never drank, so weird things. It was in a movie too called Divergent. And yeah, the song's called Find You. I'm trying to play it in tune. I care about that more than you do.
Silent love's calling faith, shatter me through your hallways, into echoes you can hear, and rehearse the way you heal. Make them dance just like you, cause you make me move. Yeah, you always make me go. Steps, build a city that dreams for two. If you lose yourself, I will find you. High on words we almost used, fireworks with a wet fuse, flying planes with paper wheels to the same Achilles heel. Come dance just like you, cause you make me move. Yeah, you always make me go. I'll run away with your footsteps. I'll build a city that dreams for two. If you lose yourself, I will find you. Like you, cause you make me move. I'll run away with your footsteps. I'll build a city that dreams for two. If you lose yourself, I will find you. You make me move. Yeah, you always make me go.
The COVID sessions, that's accurate. This was another one that a lot of people wanted to hear. I don't know if I've ever played it. So we're gonna play it. I feel like this is my least put together show. In terms of, I don't know how to play any of these songs. I'm really winging it and I'm sorry. So this is a song I did with my buddy RAC 100 years ago. And we filmed the video for it. Premise where we were playing outdoors with a bunch of mannequins. And we stood outside in, I don't know, 110 degree heat maybe? For 2 days straight, just getting killed by the sun. It was so hot. No sunscreen, of course, because why would we do that? That would be the smart thing to do. So the real kicker here is that the director of the video lost all of the footage. So we had to reshoot the video. So this was actually the reshoot of the video that we had shot like 6 months prior or 6 weeks prior. So we stand outside, it's 1,000 degrees out and we're just getting beamed by the sun. And I wake up the day after the shoot and I am a very, very, very dark brown. And obviously by default, I'm a very pale person, but I looked like I had just gotten off a carnival cruise, but not in a good way, not in a restful way. It looked purposeful or something. And that happened to be the day of the MTV Movie Awards that we were performing at. So I got to play my first MTV Awards with the worst tan you can imagine. It was humiliating. It's your worst nightmare. It's actually what your worst nightmare is made of, was that. Lived that, got through it, you know. Still can't really Google that time period. But we got a cool song out of it. Also not really like suited for acoustic guitar, so we'll see what happens here. This is called Cheap Sunglasses. I always forget the words too. Really selling this one for you guys.
Right through you.
fuck, what are the words? Let's Google this shit. Cheap sunglasses lyrics are AC. Got it.
You're so dramatic, and I want it better than you're super radical, the way you are. You're double vision, and a new religion, and hers and his, and then the way you are. Blue skies, white eyes, won't blind me, everything I do. Your shades, they can't shade in the sunlight, in the sunlight. Limousines get stuck in traffic. We all know you're made of plastic. You may seem like something classic, but your cheap sunglasses, your cheap sunglasses, I'll see right through you. Cheap sunglasses, your cheap sunglasses, and I see right through you. And I see right through you. I see right through you.
I mean, that deserved a boo. I should have had the boo ready. I didn't even remember the words. Fuck, man. That was a really fun song. I love REC. We have a new song coming up too on his record. He's putting out a record in a couple of weeks, and we've wrote a song called Oakland, but it's about San Francisco. It's really good. You'll hear it really soon. I'm obsessed with these ice drinks. They're called sparkling ice, and they're absolutely terrible for you. I think they're worse for you than Fresca. But fuck, they taste so good. I can't stop. It's like, it's the carbonation and how it hits your throat. It hurts so good. It's gonna be next week's song. Hurts so good. Sparkling ice. On the throat. So I had this friend in New York. This is actually the same trip that I wrote Something in the Air, and she had just posted a picture online that said something about, I think it was an eating disorder that she was struggling with at the time, and I had no idea that she was going through that. And this song kind of just popped out of it. It was a little bit of an imaginary conversation that we had but didn't have, and I sent it to her and made sure she was comfortable with the song being out in the world, because it has her name and it's called Alice. And luckily she was gracious enough to let me do that with that little imaginary conversation. So this is called Alice.
Alice knows the finer things. Life were waiting for her with silver knives. Eat her alive. She bites her name, both her arms, as deep as you could know her skinny lies. She won't cry. A day alone could feel so heavy. Life is hard enough already. Wish that she could see she matters to me. world's a better place to be since Alice started happening to me. You never know the place she goes, left to her devices, it's self-assault. It's not her fault. She smiles and she won't complain. Wanna tell her that it's okay to live in the gray. She wants so bad to feel steady. Spin the globe and throw confetti. Wish that she could see as shitty as it seems. World's a better place to be. Alice started happening to me. Stay, 'cause everybody loves you. Everybody was you, misguided by the shame. Stay, put it all behind you. Put it all behind you. Don't fade. A day alone could feel so heavy. And life is hard enough already. I wish that she could see she matters to me. World's a better place to be. Alice started happening. Alice started happening. Alice started happening to me.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for your encouraging clapping at home that I know is happening. I could hear. Oh! I forgot to tell you about my aunts. So, there's a group on Facebook that I joined. And it's called something to the tune of a group where we all pretend we're part of an ant colony. Now, that's not verbatim, but it's something close to that. So I joined it. Basically, it's people just posting pictures of ants or of things that could potentially involve an ant, like a pastry, let's say. And then everybody has to encourage what activity ants in a colony would encourage. So if it's a picture of a donut on a kitchen table, everybody starts just going, lift. But they do it with a space in between each letter. And this group has 1.2 million people. It's no joke. It's such a vibe. Munch. Yeah, somebody's doing munch and bite. See, you know what's up. Eat. Yeah. Crunch. Yeah, you guys get it. That's what this group is. It's so fucking... It's weird. It's like... It's definitely a bit, but... I think this could have only have happened like in this particular time where everybody's home and looking for something weird to get involved in. And I'm so into it. I found it in like the middle of the night a couple of nights ago, and I woke up and totally forgot that I had found it. And now my entire feed is just updates in that group of people just being like, lift, slurp. Slurp's my other favorite one. I like when people say slurp. Big bite. Yeah, exactly. You got it. This song has nothing to do with ants. I just can't play an out of tune guitar. It'll haunt me in my dreams. By the way, snarks are having a moment. If you don't know what a snark is, it's this little thing. It's a tuner on your guitar, goes on top of your guitar. and I see them on a lot of, like, I don't think you'd be caught dead with it typically. Usually, you wouldn't use, like, have a show where you were using your snark, but only one way to tune in on these live streams. It's a snark.
Guess that some of that wear may be my fault, and I can't quite figure out which fight had been our last, or if that one even mattered much at all. Disillusioned as snow angels who thought their wings were permanent. In seclusion you were faithful, or at least hid your finer print. Dumb I was in hindsight to think that I could really know much of anything about anything, though. And just being in Los Angeles bring me to mind, and does wine and Billie Holiday still make you cry? And your call, is it to open up a door to better days? Is it simple as the way you want to say, are you okay? Empty cup can't fill another. Why did that take us so long to figure out? Sides of you where I swore I could love her, but to love takes so much more than knowing how. And I'm still in that apartment where we were big kids playing house, where we bought the cups and curtains to imitate settling down. I kept some of our pictures and I wear my birthday watch to remind me of the man I'm glad I'm not. Does your new boyfriend know how much I still mean to you? Do you change some of the details for more convenient truth? Can he translate how you hold his hand into levels of your pain? Does he know to ask despite what you may say? Are you okay? You're a child on an airplane, you fear what's out of your control. And you love New York, cause it was somewhere else for you to go. Dyed your hair so you could look your mirror in the eye. Pretend she's someone you don't recognize. So it's time to lose my number and let the past be where we stay. When you've had too much to drink again, someone else can hold your waist. We were never quite as good as how your memory replays. And I don't owe you no answer when you say, are you okay? Are you okay?
Thanks for all these requests tonight, guys. I'm playing some sort of festival this weekend. Some like sort of online festival for a radio station in Kansas City. There's a lot of cool bands on it. I'll post some info. I think I'm doing like 3 songs or something. Morning, Kim. We put a new song out last week that absolutely should not be played acoustic, but I'm gonna play it acoustic. And we have a video coming for it too. It's actually a really cool video. We all filmed it, like we filmed ourselves with a bunch of props, and we got as creative as we possibly could get in quarantine. I'm excited for you guys to see it. It came out way better than I thought it was gonna come out. But yeah, it's totally a band song. There's no business playing acoustic, but whatever, fuck it. Called Kangaroo. I guess I have a thing with animals. There's kangaroo and this ant group, and then I had like a gecko or some sort of lizard in here earlier. He's still in here, but I got him to move to the smaller room, like the entrance, and I'm working my way to get him back out into the wild, because this is no place for a lizard. There's nothing for a lizard to do here. Kangaroo.
Rainbows coming out the back of my car. I'm so expert, I teach my own seminars. My spirit animal's a kangaroo. My Patagonia's powder blue. If you wanna see me, look over the moon. You sent me to spaceman and I let go. Phoenix, I'm burning, I can feel it in my soul. Cross my heart into the great big world. I found my calling, I could feel it in my soul. I got a bathtub, the shape of a swimming pool. A drum set and a telly that stays in tune. Wife who's got a better job. She backs me in my indie rock. I'm kidding about the indie part, I ain't that cool. But they sent me to spaceman and I let go. Phoenix, I'm burning, I can feel it in my soul. Cross my heart into the great big world. I found my calling, I can feel it in my soul. Supposed to be. I'm right where I'm supposed to be. Right where I'm supposed to be. Right where I'm supposed to be. You sent me to spaceman and I let go. Phoenix, I'm burning, I could feel it in my soul. Cross my heart into the great big world. I found my calling, I could feel it in my. You sent me to spaceman and I let go. Phoenix, I'm burning, I could feel it in my soul. Cross my heart into the great big world. I found my calling, I can feel it in my soul. I'm right where I'm supposed to be. Right where I'm supposed to be. Right where I'm supposed to be. Right where I'm supposed to be.
That's it. That's Kangaroo. And that's my show. Thanks for coming. Thanks for requesting songs so I have some sort of idea of what to play. And yeah. I hope everybody's staying safe and staying healthy and doing what you're supposed to do and not going too stir crazy. And I hope all these concerts and little living room shows that people are doing is making it interesting for you. And yeah. Super happy to do these as often as possible and maybe remember some of the words to my songs, you know, maybe, not definitely, maybe. Jack Williams, what's your question? see your question, dude. I was trying to hold out for you. That's gonna get you back next week. I could try kisses back next time, yeah. Hi, Nick Brun. I think you missed the show. I don't think I have a favorite song I've written. I really dislike most of what I do, like, 2 weeks later. I think every performance is total shit, and I think most songs I write are terrible after, like, 20 minutes. 2 weeks. I do think they're really good for about 2 weeks. And then I hate them. Written in reverse is a hard one, but that could be cool. I could give that one a shot. Alright, guys. See you next time.